The world is a magnificent ecosystem that knows how to take care of its own problems. It always seeks equilibrium. The issue with carbon is no different.
Biomimicry is this idea that, you know, we do synthetically what nature does itself. So you're trying to essentially mimic or replicate some sort of a biological process. So effectively, you're using a natural template. The oceans are by far the largest sink for carbon dioxide that we have. 25 to 30% of all of the carbon dioxide that humans emit into the atmosphere is removed and stored by the oceans year upon year. We need to be activating and leveraging the ocean's storage capacity for carbon dioxide. What Equatic is based on is actually just leveraging a very large natural system and providing a synthetic intervention to it.
It's the same chemistry as what nature does, only 99,000 times faster.
We're taking a very natural process, we're bringing it into an industrial facility, we're accelerating it with the provision of electricity, and doing carbon dioxide removal and hydrogen production all at the same time.
The Earth as a closed system has a fixed amount of carbon. The carbon cycle is the process by which carbon continually travels to and from the atmosphere into the oceans, into the land sinks. Some of this carbon is also stored as fossil fuels. And when we burn those fossil fuels, what happens is we're releasing this vast amount of carbon back into the atmosphere. And changes the fluxes of carbon between the different sinks, and this could have impacts in ecosystems. So humans emit more than 37 billion tons of CO2 per year, and this is a huge number that has big impacts in our ecosystems. The oceans regulate the Earth's temperature. And currently, it removes about 30% of our annual CO2 emissions from our industrial processes. That has side effects, so that means that all of this CO2 that is being absorbed by the ocean causes what we call ocean acidification, where the pH of the ocean is decreasing, which is harmful to ecosystems.
So the question that we were trying to ask is, how do you really exploit and activate the ocean's capacity for carbon dioxide storage, but without inducing acidification? The idea behind Equatic is really quite simple.
The process starts with seawater intake. So the seawater is fed into electrolyzers.
You use electricity to break seawater into acid and base. You use the base to be able to absorb carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, but also remove it from the ocean simultaneously.
And then this is the analyte. We react rock with this acid. So it will neutralize all of the acidity so that we avoid any degassing that could potentially happen if you decrease the pH. We mix these two streams together before we discharge it back into the ocean, where the carbon that we've removed is going to be permanently stored.
What this allows you to do is to reduce the atmospheric accumulation of CO2, store it in the oceans, and activate the ocean's capacity very substantially to be able to hold CO2 within it.
In addition to carbon dioxide removal, one of our products is also hydrogen, specifically green hydrogen, which is an alternative source of energy. And this is energy that is produced without fossil fuels. And this is something that we could use to offset the energy costs within the plant and then sell it to other industries as a renewable energy source.
What we have here, in fact, is a technology solution that could help us in a meaningfully large way both solve the climate crisis, but simultaneously to produce green hydrogen at a scale that's big enough to provide energy supplies to displace fossil fuels all around the world, which is going to be a really important part of how we actually get away from ongoing climate change.
Our goal is to produce green hydrogen at a rate at which carbon dioxide removal is free, based on the sale of hydrogen from our process.
The plant that we're building now in Singapore is the world's largest ocean-based carbon removal facility. We've thought about building these systems to be perfectly modular. And what that means is you scale up by numbering up units. It's not by building bigger and bigger plants. And this is, I think, fundamentally different from what we've done over the course of the Industrial Revolution so far. The measurement of carbon dioxide removal is particularly important because it's important to try and identify the value of a carbon credit that you would generate. It delivers confidence to both the buyer but to the community at large that you are accomplishing what you said you would do. The solution of climate change is a time-bound problem that needs to happen in a matter of decades. And so you don't have time to wait for natural cycles to do what they need to do. We need to actually exert engineering interventions to make them happen at a scale that's relevant, but also impactful.
I think that there's been a lot of support from government, from industry, and that really validates the technology that we're moving in the right direction.
We've come a really long way from doing this in a thimble full of seawater, so to speak, in a laboratory. It's one of these things where failure is not an option.